It's important that we understand the skeletal anatomy of the anterior talofibular ligament attachments, having an awareness of the location of the tibia, the fibula and the talus is very important, and also understanding how to correctly position the patient to enable the ligament to be on stretch and to be dynamically examined will assist your examination of this area. We can see here where the blue marker is, that the orientation of the anterior talofibular ligament is actually very horizontal. So it's important to understand that and to consider that when moving your probe and when dynamically assessing. As we look now at the live scan image, you'll see two very distinct hyperechoic bony landmarks. Laterally, you have the fibula, which has a very flat appearance and is much smaller than the more medially placed tibia, which is much wider and has a very much a curved appearance on its superior margin as we're looking at it. As you start to take your probe more distally, those two bones will come together naturally and form what is known as the syndesmosis. And at that point, we know that we can find the anterior inferior tibiofibular ligament, which can be sustaining injuries during high ankle sprains. As we go beyond that, we see the distinct appearances now of the talus with that dark hypoechoic layer on top of it. And you know then you're in the right region for the anterior talofibular ligament. And with an angulation of your probe, usually the distal end to go a bit more inferior, you'll see that very distinct linear appearance of the ligament. It tends to have a hypoechoic appearance, but the superior margin tends to have a very crisp outline in relation to the subcutaneous tissue. Check the talus and the fibula for cortical change, most likely avulsion injuries off the fibula, and you can dynamically stress test this ligament as well in this position into plantar flexion and inversion. You can also go on to have a look at this ligament in a different view, which is a short axis view. This doesn't tend to get utilised so much in clinical practice, I have to say, but it can be a useful go-to if you're looking at a ligament and you're struggling to work out if there is a full thickness tear through the ligament. So moving to a short axis view confidently can enable you to have a little bit of extra information to help you plan your final report.